The long-nosed chimaera is a rarely seen fish that is closely related to sharks. Just like a shark, a chimaera has a skeleton composed mainly of cartilage, but lacks the flattened body form of a ray or a skate. They're smooth-skinned without the dermal denticles, commonly known as scales, that you'll find on a shark. Chimaeras live on the muddy bottom of the sea and mainly feed on shellfish and invertebrates in cooler temperatured water. Our next fish is the gulper eel, also commonly known as the pelican eel or the umbrella mouth gulper. The gulper eel can grow to 80 centimeters in length. It feeds mainly on crustaceans, but will also eat fish, invertebrates, and cephalopods, otherwise known as squids or octopi. The gulper eel has a mouth that can swallow something much larger than itself and a stomach that will stretch accordingly to accommodate the larger prey. The prey will rest in a lower jaw pouch, much like that of a pelican. The tail is long and whip-like with an organ on the end that produces light. Fishermen who have caught gulper eels in nets have reported the tail tying itself in many knots. This lovely fellow is the viperfish. Easily recognized by its smile and its huge curving teeth, this fish will actually travel into shallower waters at night where prey is more plentiful. This behavior is known as vertically migrating, and it's a common practice among many species of deep sea fishes. The viperfish's teeth do not actually fit in its mouth because of their giant size. Instead, they curve back over the top of its head almost to where its eyes are. It uses a light-producing photosphore on the long dorsal fin to attract prey. These light producers can be found all over the viperfish's body, especially the head and the jaws. Scientists are not sure why so many species of deep-sea fishes have such long dagger-like teeth, but it is something that is definitely unique among these fishes. The last creature we're going to take a look at is simply known as phronema. The phronema is a type of amphipod and has evolved to be completely transparent as a defense mechanism. The goal of this survival strategy is to disappear completely into its surroundings. This works especially well in the murky deep waters in which it resides. This shrimp-like creature has recently been discovered residing in deep-sea mountain range in the Atlantic Ocean. They grow to about an inch long and feed on plankton. A type of plankton known as a salp serves a secondary purpose for this creature. The phronema will actually eat out the insides of the salp to use as a home for its eggs. That's all I have for you today. Hopefully there will be more in the future, but thank you for watching.